Burton was born in County Clare in 1816 and he moved quite quickly to Dublin. He started off his artistic career as a painter of miniatures, so doing miniature portraits, and he moved to London and he became known then for his large-scale watercolour drawings, which were of narrative images, genre scenes. One of his very famous was the Iron Fisherman's Drowned Child, which he painted in the 1840s, and it was greatly acclaimed. People felt this very moving, tragic image of a father and a whole family weeping over their drowned child. To the Victorian audience, it was incredibly popular. The Meeting on the Third Stairs then was painted in 1864 when Burton was at the height of his career. He really was feted. He showed his work at the Royal Academy and at the Old Watercolour Society's exhibitions, and he was highly regarded. And when this painting was shown in 1864, the public loved it. It's been loved really since that time. George Eliot, who was a friend of Burton's, wrote of its romance and said that he took a theme which could potentially have been very vulgar and raised it to the highest level imaginable. And she also noted the face of the knight, and she said, "He's a man to whom the kiss is a sacrament." So you can just see that the romance was really recognised even at the very beginning. It went on exhibition in 1864 and it was snapped up by a dealer. They realised its potential. But interestingly, Burton himself held on to the copyright because he was aware that it could be useful and make money potentially as a print. The Iron Fisherman's Drowned Child had been made into a print by the Irish Art Union and had been incredibly popular and sold many hundreds of copies. So he held on to copyright, but the painting itself was sold from dealer to dealer and highly regarded. 10 years after he painted The Meeting on the Third Stairs, Frederick William Burton became director of the National Gallery in London. He was a very successful director. He acquired many very wonderful paintings for that collection, including Leonardo's Virgin on the Rocks, which is one of the best loved paintings in that collection. But sadly for us, he stopped painting around that time. He was director of the National Gallery for 20 years until his retirement in 1884, and he was knighted in the middle of his tenure, so he was highly regarded by the British and so on. When he died in 1900, he was highly regarded on both sides of the Irish Sea, and the National Gallery of Ireland put on a major retrospective exhibition of his work. Many of the works were borrowed from Margaret Stokes. She was the younger sister of Whitley Stokes, whose poem had inspired Burton to paint The Third Stairs. And she had many works by Burton, including a little while before his death, she had bought The Meeting on the Third Stairs. And when he died then, it was on show in the National Gallery of Ireland, thanks to Margaret Stokes. The Viceroy's wife, Lady Cadogan, actually asked Margaret Stokes, could she borrow the painting to hang in the Viceregal Lodge, which is now Oras an Uachtaráin. And Margaret Stokes agreed, and there's a letter in the gallery's archives. She writes to the registrar of the gallery just asking him could it be moved to the Viceregal Lodge. So I think it's quite nice that it hung in that illustrious building, and it actually hung in what was called then the Queen's Sitting Room, a room which Queen Victoria had been in just the previous year. It's a work which many people mistake for an oil painting because the colours are so rich, beautiful, rich, deep blues and reds. It reminds people of the Pre-Raphaelite painters as well, although that group had kind of fizzled out, if you like, by 1864 when Burton was exhibiting The Third Stairs. But certainly he seems to have been influenced by their use of colour and their interest in these romantic narrative scenes. So it ties him in with that group in some senses. It was exhibited obviously in this magnificent gilt frame. It's shown in the same frame today, and that again gives people this impression that it is an oil painting. But it's not an oil painting, it's a work on paper, and it's very vulnerable to damage by overexposure to light. And that's why we have to limit the hours, so people almost have to make a pilgrimage to come and see the picture.
It's great that The Meeting on the Third Stairs is Ireland's favourite painting, and it's currently on view, as any visitors will have seen, in Room 1. We have it in a specially made cabinet, which is to protect the very, very delicate glazes and watercolour paints from too much exposure to the light. I suppose there's a real balance over trying to make sure that people can see it and at the same time protecting it from overexposure. When you're looking at it, you're looking through some very special double laminate UV protecting low reflective glass, which will add to its protection. And as it's obvious, the cabinet doors, when they close, they don't let any light in at all. The reason why it's so important to protect them from the light is that it'll fade the watercolour very, very rapidly. In our own time life, so we would be able to see a big difference if we weren't very careful about protecting it from constant exposure. It's the same with all the works in prints and drawings. We tend to rotate the exhibitions, have them only open for max 4 months of the year. And then that would be done on a rotation basis. But because this is so popular, we want it to be able to be accessible to as many people as possible. And so this is the kind of flexible approach that we've tried to come up with.